All right, now back to our top story. Matt Lauer fired, NBC News, here with reaction. Florida Attorney General Pam Bondi. From The Hollywood Reporter, we have Marissa Guthrie and trial attorney Rebecca Rose Woodland. Thanks to all of you. I don't even know where to begin. It's like more coming out by the minute about what has really been going on at NBC, and all of it is despicable.
It's horrific. And I have to ask, what did NBC management know here? Matt Lauer allegedly had a button under his desk. Someone had to install this button that would lock the door from his desk.
Yeah, so, I don't think he did it himself.
Well, these are the questions. These are the big questions. If he was acting alone, how could he have done this with a button under his desk, asking people to come to his hotel rooms to bring pillows? Someone had to know. These women claim that they reported it not to current management, but to previous management,
and nothing happened. Keep reading the word abuse, not just misconduct.
Abuse. Because if you're locked in a room, Sean, that amounts to much more than an interaction. That amounts to enclosed in a space that could seem like force.
These things are not consensual. This is where we're now, and it's also the position of power issue that keeps coming up again and again.
Now,
we haven't really heard from Matt Lauer today.
No,
he doesn't seem to be denying anything or saying anything. What do we glean from that?
Well, I think Matt and he is now has some independent publicists working with him, and they were waiting for these other reports and these other accusations before they said anything. I expect they will release some sort of statement, but yes, the entitlement of Matt Lauer, Charlie Rose, Harvey Weinstein, and the fact that what all of these have in common is the behavior was an open secret, and nobody did anything about it.
Let me go to Pam Bondi, because I think there are also legal issues that come in here. What do you, as you read all of this, legally speaking, do you see any potential trouble for him? And I'm not talking about civilly.
Well, certainly, depending on what Rebecca just laid out, whether the door was locked, exactly what these women say. But, Sean, I think there also may be a lot of liability on the part of Andy Lack. I think he's going to have a lot of explaining to do. As a prosecutor, Sean, I always look at a timeline. Look at the timeline here. Variety and the New York Times had been investigating this, they said, for 2 months. So that takes us back to September. Then on November 8th, NBC announces mysteriously that Matt Lauer's no longer going to the Olympics. It's going to be Megyn Kelly, and congratulations to her for that. Then on November 27th, 2 days ago, Andy Lack says that's the first time that they've heard about these allegations against Matt Lauer. So there may be, I think Andy Lack's going to have a lot of answers that he's going to have to be responding to his superiors at NBC.
Let me make
myself clear. These women are heroes for coming forward.
I'm trying to understand, because one person comes out, and then there's always this avalanche.
Sure.
Which tells me so many, that there's a pattern of behavior in all of this.
With Sean, all these, it takes
as
one
a prosecutor,
woman.
As the attorney general, obviously, of Florida, is that common? Like one,
very
then five,
common.
Then 10?
Very common. I'm sorry, there's a bit of a delay tonight. Very common, Sean. In fact, that's what we see. One woman, it takes one woman to come forward, and that's why the Me Too movement is so important. And if a woman comes forward in Florida against some loser in Tallahassee, I'm going to stand beside her. And I think all women will, for anyone who comes out around this country, whether it's some icon in Hollywood or whether it's someone huge in the media industry, but one woman comes forward, that's all it takes. And then other women say, we can't be scared anymore. We can come forward as well.
Do you also always have to have the presumption of innocence, Pam?
Of course you do. That's why the women have to come forward. I've always said that, and that's why these brave women are coming forward. Now, as Rebecca described, if they truly are, could have been the victim, and we don't know any of that yet, of a rape, of a sexual assault. If that's true, then their identity by law will be protected. Yeah. No one can reveal their identity, right. And they deserve to be protected as victims of a sexual assault, if that is the case, but we do not know that yet. And of course, anyone is innocent until proven guilty, but you can't take it further unless women continue to forward. So very important.
I agree with Pam wholeheartedly. She's a great prosecutor in Florida. We need someone like that here in New York. We already have a task force around Harvey Weinstein in New York, in California. Possibly this task force will increase its scope for Matt Lauer or whomever else at NBC may happen upon. There may be more here. You know, his booker was fired. Mr. Zimmerman was fired already for inappropriate sexual conduct. Now, this is someone who was with Matt Lauer throughout the course of his time at NBC. I find that questionable. I find that odd that he was fired. Now Matt Lauer has been let go, apparently only as a result of something NBC found out on Monday. I agree with Pam Bondi that that sounds questionable as well.
Well, Ann Curry described the Today Show as a boys' network when she was ousted, and I think we're seeing evidence of that in these reports, for sure.
Pam, you were saying?
Sean, Savannah Guthrie is a friend. She's one of the nicest people I know, and she got blindsided this morning because she believed in Matt Lauer. I'm sure she still does. It's her friend. And, you know, she had to read that statement on the air this morning, and I felt for her. I felt for Hoda, as well as all the other women at NBC. But the women have to come forward, and I think other women will stand beside them.
All right. Thank you all for being with us. And when we